And is works module a part of Digit's latest version? No, it is not there. So it is only available in the monolith version of the ERP. Yeah.
Perfect. We can move on, Satish.
There you go. So you can have multiple detailed types mapped to a particular GL code, account code, and then save it. Okay. Yeah. So before we get on to the transactions, I'll just give a brief of these two masters. Since if finance is used as a standalone module without having works works management, wherein the majority of expenditure bills or contractor bills are flowing in, and inventory module where the purchase related expense bills are flowing in. So for contingent expenses, we have something called expense bill. For these expenses, or expenditure bills, if there is no module integrated to this, be it part of the Digit or be it part of be it a third party module, you users or the accounts section can create a basic work order to track all the bills against a particular work order. Say for example, work order, I'm just giving you a sample work order number. So work order number, work order date, order number. Okay, let me see. Let's view our existing one instead of creating a new one. These are the basic information that is captured as part of the work order. So wherein you'll have total order value. So now whenever there is a bill or there are bills created in the account section for this work order, they can keep track of the total bill amount or the total amount of all the bills not exceeding this amount. So this kind of checking and tracking can be made. So with this basic works accounting module made. Okay. So that is the reason why they create a basic work order with this information. Yeah, to whom it is awarded to, the contractor whom it is awarded to, the total order value of the work order, advance paid so far, the fund to which it is to be accounted in, and department in which it is. Once again.
Sorry for that. I think it's a piece of
sorry. Sorry, I'm not part of. So I just had to pause it.
Yeah. Hey, no worries. Hey, so which screen are you on? You're still on the Checkmaster search screen, right?
No, I'm on the work order screen. So you're not able to see that?
No, it's not changing.
Oh, sorry. Oh.
Okay. Yeah. Now it's fine.
Oh, so then the modified chart of accounts also was not visible.
It wasn't, no.
Okay.
No worries. You can just briefly walk through that.
Okay, sorry. So it was, okay. So this is, I think, for Rajesh, who had asked that question. So like, yeah, you can map multiple sub-ledger codes to a particular account code or ledger code. Okay. So I think after this I was on the work order purchase order screen wherein I was creating a work order. So this basic work order information that you capture as part of the work order masters. So each work order that is sent to the account section will be recorded here. And subsequently all the bills generated against this work order will be tracked against this work order that is created here. So this will have basic information like total order value, advance paid to the contractor, and who is the contractor to whom this particular work order was issued to. Okay, I'll just show you one of the work order that is already there in the system. Yeah. So this is the work order information that is loaded. So here we say to which fund it belongs to, which department it belongs to, and so on. So this will be used for creating bills and accounting of vouchers of those bills. Okay. Yeah. So once work order is there, the bills creation for these work orders can be processed in the system as and when the bills are submitted to the account section. And it will also track what is the total amount, whether it is exceeding all the total amount of all the bills for that work order is exceeding the work order amount or not. So those checks are also enabled in that. Okay.